MCTV.
It's your boy, Ezra, from the scene. I'm here with RJ Clark. Yeah, we're checking in on the MCTV podcast. Yo, it's getting close to Christmas. Right around the corner. Nah, I like Christmas. You don't like Christmas?
I like having gas, too. I like giving people gifts. Which is so cool.
Hey, why was Santa Claus so mad?
Miss Claus took away all his holy holies.
That would be one of those
too. The original. The dream that came up with that, I don't know if
he can tell that. He can tell that.
There's a word for it. Look up the Mike Tyson Roy Jones fight. look it up.
Like, you can do it on a computer with right on the level of the Roy Jones is doing pretty heavy. I mean, and who wouldn't be, right? Going against Mike Tyson. But Mike didn't seem like he was too many steps behind. He was okay. Mike was holding back. He was ready to go. He was going to lose the fight.
Yeah.
He was ready to go. He was excited at the end. Mike was like, yeah, he didn't pull up that same window. He just typed in Roy Jones, Mike Tyson fight card.
Yeah,
he should be able to pull it up. But it was an entertaining fight. I was supposed to see. I don't know what happened. I was like, you can't beat me up. So he called me all the way up there.
ladies know she's calling her son the speed dial.
Where is it number two? She's going into the car. I was like, tell her.
so many years, I was able to attend it, I want to say, 4 times. And as far as I know, it's no longer going on. It ended 2 years ago. 2019 was the last one. And it has ceased to return. It was put on by the dude that Robin Sayers Entertainment in Minneapolis, Atlas Fields Club and their host squad, and had 5 stages. It's essentially a brought back old school scribble jam from Cincinnati where a lot of these MCs came up, and they redid it, but they brought it back with bigger headliners to pay the bills for exactly a much bigger audience instead of just people that are solely passionate about hip hop and solely there for the B-boys and the MC battle and the DJ battle and all that. The headliners come and perform on the main stage, and so you get to see people like Run the Jewels and Lil Wayne and Wu-Tang and Erykah Badu and so people buy tickets and travel from across the globe to come see this. And it was hosted by Sway in the morning, and Sway would show up and he would broadcast live from the Ron Sayers store, Fifth Element, up in Minneapolis, and they would go live and do Sway in the morning the day before. And they would have a pre-party at the Christmas Club at First Half. They would have a pre-party at First Half, and then they would close it out tonight, do the show at First Half, and have another party. And it was a whole weekend. It was Memorial Day weekend. And that's my wife's birthday. And so, it was kind of, we walked over the weekend and we took it. Yeah. It was hip hop mecca. It was amazing, bro. It was so cool, to get to see so many people in one place. I would literally get the lineup. I'd have to go through and pick who I wanted to see and where I had to be and write myself like a little itinerary so I'd know, oh man, I gotta get over to the main stage right now, or I gotta get over to the atmosphere. So then I asked them, are there 5 stages? And they would do like 50, 60 bands, 40, 50 bands, whatever it was. But then they had a whole other separate tent where they had DJs spinning all day. And they had everybody from Blaze One to, you name it, you know what I mean? And then they also had B-Boy Dance-Offs and MC Battles, where they had all the B-Boy Dance-Offs. Yeah, I mean, I like that with B-Boy Dance-Offs. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Dudes up there popping and that's that, really getting it in. And this really encompassed all of that. Not to mention, I'm thinking they had a whole wall of graffiti where artists could go up there and they got a section of the wall to do their draft. And it was, I'll throw some pictures in here from previous events I went to in Scribble Jam, but it was cool. I can't think of, I think the last Scribble Jam we went to in 2019, they had that by Wu-Tang. I want to say it had 50,000 in attendance. So it wasn't, and then it was on the Minnesota State Fairgrounds in St. Paul on the Midway. They took a loss. I mean, it was a big event to put on. You know what I mean? It was no small investment, but it was, I think they did well. I don't know. 2019 did well, too. But it was just too bad. Yeah, I mean, it was so cool. It's 300 miles away. It's a couple hours up the road. You know what I mean? You get to catch a limo. Yeah. I mean, you get to see, literally, I got to see DMX perform. I got to see Tech N9ne perform. Tech N9ne was there numerous times. It was him and Chris Calico last time. Run the Jewels were there that year. Wu-Tang headlined. Russ was there that year. I'm trying to think of the whole line up. It's been a couple years, but Russ was on stage and talking about, I'm the only one that matters, and I'm the only one that matters on this stage today, and it created a lot of animosity, not necessarily amongst the fans per se, but out of the artists, the Goth in particular. Goth took a special defended. Prof was like, for those who don't know, Prof is a hip-hop artist out of Minneapolis that's got a Call of the Fallen
He was signed to Roundtable Entertainment with Atmosphere and Murs and everybody. And he's solo now, but he took personal insult by what Russ was saying up on stage. There was one girl in the front row that I saw when I was in the convention. She was holding the side of the floor, only came for Russ. He must have locked onto that. And he was like, I can't remember the exact statement. We're talking 55,000 people. I don't know a tremendous amount about the Beast's career. I would imagine that was probably one of the biggest festivals that he had played at that point in time, and probably one of the biggest concerts. He was like, fuck anybody else. I may not get this quote 100% right. Somebody's got video footage of it somewhere, but the gist of it was, the gist of it was, fuck everybody else. I'm on this stage right now. I run this shit. And this is the main stage that had hosted Eric Abadou prior to him. Wu-Tang was coming on next. There were people out there doing the And it was, I might even have a little video footage of it, because I was standing on the sidelines and I was just like, what in the fuck is going on? It blew my mind, because I was familiar with the Cherry Blossom video, and I thought he was cool, you know, this guy. I didn't have any beef with him, and I wasn't specifically drawn to him at that point in time, but for somebody to be so braggadocious and up there and so conceited and just be like, right? And you're talking in the presence of greatness. I mean, scratch any one of the individual artists off here or there, you still have a whole list of other people to bless that stage that day, so you can't be up there just right. Yeah, so in 2023, now he said a big toast about this in April, a few months back, I guess. Hip hop will be 50 years old in 2023. That's a milestone, bro. I wonder where he's going to. I was kind of thinking about that. So 2023, that's about 50 years, that's 80, right? So, that would be 2033. So, 70. It goes back. I mean, it started in New York, in Brooklyn, I believe. They credit Grandmaster Cass as being the first dude to spin a record. He was like at a house party. He just started messing with the record, and I realized it made this sound. I believe Grandmaster Cass and Cody Day were the first dude to scratch on a record. And the dude was doing house parties and whatnot, but they weren't quite scratching. But then all of a sudden, this new form came along, and it was pioneered in New York. And they realized that you could hook up two records, you could fade from one record to the next, and talk back and forth, and you can't even. I was 1980s when I wrote the book. $5 signs on it.
You tell that him a little money out of the jail with the movie.
I mean, well, Drake, who doesn't want to work with Drake? You know what I mean? Drake's like the top restaurant of that. I can't think of a decent that anybody wants to. I mean, I love Drake, but I think both of them are amazing producers, and they have their own things, but as far as a milestone, you know, just to trade the beats by Dre, Drake, the end of the old movie, you know what I mean? It's a little bit higher. Not saying nothing about anybody's beats or the production, but just a status mark to be able to go, yeah, fuck it, you got to make that good. You know, however it goes, I would say there's a little bit more of a notch up. Oh, no, man. I mean, that time when things were doing this time with Justin, that's when Justin went from like, here to like, boom. And then he had that stuff with Nelly Furtado, you know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah, he had a moment there where, damn it for real, they both had their moments where they had their rock and pop and had their sound out there, you know?
Talk about
Jay was first.
Yeah.
Jay was most definitely first.
Just a little five from the year in the game.
So, Sam did his thing with Justin.
Yep.
You know, Pharrell has been everywhere. You know, Pharrell got more songs than people don't know anything about Pharrell.
Yeah.
What's his name?
No interest.
That was what? That was good. So you got the production thing, right?
Yeah.
You know, that boy, he got
mold.
You know, he got a lot of. That is, I love him like my brother. I love my brother.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I love the kind of do this.
Yeah, okay.
I like some R&B, but you love it.
I like it some R&B.
I'm doing a little sprinkling of it, but I got another bars. I got another bars.
Focused. I mean, there's so many people in his cool people. You know what I mean? Maybe they come up with a riff. It's like Timbo, right? We watched that master, he's at a master class. And then somebody was left home together and they pass it off to the next guy. And they
look
at the harmony or whatever. And then they all are very mean and you know, and it's like, just fools on it. You know, it's just kind of a collaboration. Even though it might come out of the beat club.
Katie had a verse.
I have yet to see one. I just saw the 3-6 and the Bone Thugs one jumped off and got a little
It got a little crazy.
I didn't see that one.
I think Booty Bone might throw a water bottle at somebody. He was angry. I think God got involved. I'm not talking about that. Don't hit me. It was something over religion, I believe, was the issue. And they were trying to get 360 to denounce Satan. And so they Satan to the music, and then they needed them to denounce Satan. And then he wasn't happy with the. You can look it up on TMZ. I don't want to spoil nobody in this. But basically, what I got from it was that he wasn't happy with it, and he got upset, and he motioned to run out, and somehow a water bottle got thrown, and then Gangster Boo got angry, I think they ended up squashing it in the end, but it got a little tense for a minute.
So it was 3-6 and
I didn't
know about that. Yeah. It looked like we played Riley versus Cooper. That was just kind of annoying. But,
speaking of versus, Jay-Z just recently said, nobody in hell can touch their versus. In terms of, I'm assuming that means his catalog. Jay's saying, nobody can test my catalog. I'm running it. But Lil Jon apparently responded a couple of days later, and he was like, a bunch of rhymes were close to a catalog. So, I mean,
he said, what?
That's a tough one.
As far as business in the game, Jay-Z wins. I mean, you can't hardly carrying another person is a stronger business man. But if you look at the dudes to get to the upper echelon, Jay-Z, Dr. Dre, Eminem, there's a lot of other dudes that are on the cusp or in that area, but they don't perform anymore. That doesn't really happen with like who would you compare in a rock role? Journey, maybe? U2, the Beatles? But they pop up and do a show. You know what I mean? You see them every once in a while. Like, it's very seldom that you see Dr. Dre come out and perform. I mean, he's a busy dude. I'm not judging him based on it, but it's just a weird correlation that I noticed.
That's what Dr. Dre performs for.
At the smoke tour, you know, with Dre performing at the Super Bowl this year. You can't even you can't buy your way. Yeah, you haven't even invited
that thing. Yeah,
you're
you,
right? Yeah. Dre, Snoop, Mary J, and Kendrick. That's the lineup for the 2022. You know, I respect Top Dog and what they do. They got a dope lineup and their roster with Schoolboy Q and all that, but Kendrick, I was slow to fall in line with.
Didn't he have a little thing where he was like, I'm the most relevant or something? So I'm like,
oh, I didn't see that.
He still was kind of hard with
that. In his early days.
He still was kind of hard with that. I can't remember.
So I came up on J-Rock because of the whole Strange Music connection way before Kendrick. And so I didn't even really... didn't really know exactly the whole correlation, but Kendrick was even on some of the top 9 tours, I believe, with J-Rock in the early days. Yeah, and that's how the song Fragile with Tech, Kendrick, and Recognize from Mayday all came together was through them uniting and working together. Through the joint ventureship of the J-Rock album that came out in the Strange Music, and the touring with E-40 and J-Rock and Tech N9ne. And so I believe that's how that song Fragile that Tech dropped them together, you know, they all clicked up after that.
And they all, when you get up into the art, they know about
it. Well, look at, I mean,
that's a good idea.
Right, but Tech N9ne kind of got that Kevin Bacon thing, right? This Tech has worked with so many people, or an affiliate of somebody, you know what I mean? And he's worked with so many different people over the years that I feel like he's kind of the go-between. Like, if you wanted to work with whoever, you know what I mean? And you homies with Tech, and you're in that realm, you can be like, hey, I'm trying to figure out how to get a hold of you're right. Let me in, fam. I know you got a couple facts for them. You better at least pass my insurance.
I'm going to do it too, though. That's my
dude. He's a humble dude.
He'll do it to you.
He sees the way.
Right,
the potential.
Yeah.
He's pulling your way. He's like, hey, my dog's trying to holler at you.
Right.
Yeah, he does you like that. Hip hop, man. A lot of dope stuff in hip hop. That's a. Who the fuck? In the early days, I thought he was just struggling. I mean, even before I was around, you know what I mean? But when I took notice, hip hop was still struggling to get attention and make his name. Yo, MTV Raps.
I think the good women have that sour part out there, and then they got a long, long, long time.
or the converse to that would be, did that help California? Because it was so shocking, like a die-hard movie. You know what I mean? Like, not the die-hard, super shocking, but right there, it's like, oh, man, it was kind of like getting famous, like, after dropping the sex. That was a hot thing for you. I thought
that was new sex, too. Now you know me.
But this...
Yeah, I mean, it's shock value, you know?
Right.
I mean, you never know, get...
Even when it wasn't against the rap, was just being assaulted anyway because he like who?
They were
the
best. They want to be.
That's how they was.
I mean, that place for a while. I was like,
ooh. That was my first. That was my first test. That was like,
Appreciate it, pal. Oh, look, let's get it back in the game, man.
we appreciate y'all checking in. I hope you have a very Merry Christmas. Enjoy your time with your family. Your time off. If you get some time off, enjoy your food.
Enjoy your family. Enjoy the fun. You know what I'm saying? I spent my whole day because I wanted to be more about the fact that Christmas has gotten all about doing food, about what to do, about what to do. So, everyone, for this Christmas, focus on what to do. You know what I'm saying? It's better to do it than do it. So, be it.
Right. I mean, 2020. 2021 were both kind of rough years. Be thankful for the ones you got. You know what I mean? Not everybody knows all their loved ones. And so, yeah, I mean, definitely. It's been a rough couple of years. So be thankful for the ones you got. And we're going to close it out on that. We'll see you back again next week. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow so you get these videos when we talk to you. You know what I'm saying? And drop us a comment. Let us know what you think. And that helps with the algorithm too, so it boosts us up so more people see us and we can get the message out to more people. This is where hip hop lives, and we got a whole lot more stuff coming, so please. It's your boy, that motherfucker Steve, Jay Fad, you're the host. We're the Lightwood Studio, we out. Peace.